All right, what was I doing? Dicks. Right, your power is dying. Oops. Your power is dying, right? So I gotta, oh. Is it just me? Is it grayer outside than it was before? All right. You go back over here. Yes. And do another one of those dumb games. Another one of those dumb cube games. I did just badly enough at the last one that I'm a little concerned about how I'm gonna do with this next one. Might take me a couple tries. We'll see. And, oh, there is an entrance. I was like, wait, how did I get on this thing? I can't remember. Boop. Boop. And boop. Yeah. Let's just enjoy the scenery, y'all. Those clouds don't look like they belong in this world. Like, the clouds look like they should be in a much more aesthetically different game than this. I don't know. Alright, good job, everybody. Good job, team. We did it. I kind of wish that when you clicked on it, because it makes me click once to sit and then once to, like, hit the button. I wish that it was just one click that did all of that. That would be nice. I need to go to 10. Is that what she said? 10 for the power source. Feel like that was the number. 6. 2. 7. 9. Am I a dummy? 3, 5, 8, 10.
The illness in those kids wasn't accidental. Before getting sick, there was something special about them, some kind of useful quality. This quality allegedly gave them an intellectual advantage over grown-ups.
Yo, what's going on right there?
I see you. Go on in.
Dope. Merp. 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 Yeah. Cool. Let's do this thing, then. Oh, God. I'm gonna be so bad at it, though. Guys, I'm gonna be so bad at this. Alright. Let's just do it. Ugh. Ugh. Oh, yeah? Wah, 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 wah. That power source. Click 30 yellow cubes to gain the battery. Hurl cubes into the uprising stream. Create platforms. Apply yellow cubes to a white one to create a platform. Okay. Okay, wait. I've never tried to make a platform before. Oh, look at that. Wow. Wow. Oops. Uh-oh. That's not what I wanted at all. What do you do in this one? Okay. You blow up, like last time. Cool. Okay. Good to know. Aw, man. Aw, I missed. Whiffed it real bad. Aw, but when you make platforms, yellow ones spawn sometimes. That's awesome. Oh, hi. Please don't. Please no. Oops! Oh, son of a bitch. Ready. Okay. Let's see. Oh. Goodness gracious. If I need to get up higher. Ooh, it's getting a lot more difficult, huh, to get back up there. And then oops. Now I can take that guy, apply that there. Right? Yeah. Alrighty. Oop. No. Ugh. Ugh, you big asshole. Ugh. And you. I'm ready. Oh, never mind. Oh, for real? Oh no. Oops, oh no. Oops, oops. There was another white one. Shoot. Shoot dang. Ah. Yeah, got him. Got him. This guy and this guy. Oops. No, 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 no! Oh, dang it, no, no! Thank you. Yeah. Okay. And then do that. Okay. Oh, we're back on top. Oh, sick. Yeah. No. Ah. Man. I didn't remember that applying to me. Oops. I'm glad I started trying to make platforms. Oops, oh no! I right-clicked it! Oh, I'm such a dumb. No, son of a bonkers. Ugh. Rickoculus. God, I'm ruining this beautiful world. Oops! No! Sweet baby, no. I'm just gonna wait for it. Yeah! I'm close! No, why? Oh god! No! Ah, no! Come on! Son of a donk. Thank you, game. All right, patient. Just be patient. Ah! Thank you. No! Ugh. At least it doesn't, like, destroy stuff, right? Doing some of that, huh? Oops! Oh no. No, 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 no. Oh, jeez. Oh my god. It's so scary when you start falling! No! Oh my god. Do that, and then that. Okay, I got a minute then. Okay, and then... Okay. Oh, it's whirlpooling again. Cool. No! Wait, what the shit? Wait, what? It even pulls in stuff that, like... I don't understand. How is it pulling in that stuff? I don't get it. Oh, thank God. Whew. You got away. Platforms for myself before the whirlpools grab them all again. Ah, no, this one. Go right there. This must be so boring to watch, watching me try not to fall and kill myself. Yay! Okay, and then put this there. That. Oh, yeah. There we go. Here we go. Oops. Oh, no. Good. Good. Let's see. Oh, yeah, right there. Can I grab it? Yes! Yes! That was almost a problem. Yes! Oops. Don't fall. Don't fall. Don't fall. Don't fall. Not now. Not now! Oh, okay. We whirlpooling. Alright, that's fine. Alright, the end! We did it! Oh, God. Took forever. Good job, us. We figured out how to think with platforms. Sick. Oh, cool. Yeah, let's get out of here. Oops, new task. Is it put the thingu in her body? Is that my new task? It's like, oop.
I found out what special quality those kids had. They had exceptionally developed visual perception. Visual and aesthetic. For them, the shape, color, and the like of surrounding objects was of critical importance. Some things were beautiful in their eyes, others the definition of ugly. And here's the kicker. They were always in consensus. But it was that very ability that ultimately became their blight. The particulars, however, I still do not know.
What, so these kids could look at people and see whether or not their passium would be worthwhile to have? Is that the idea? Because that sounds like it's the idea. Be like, ooh, no, this person's ugly. Like, that must be why they were using those kids, right?
Did you bring the battery?
Yep.
Here it is. Let's replace it.
Go ahead. But you'll need to switch me off first.
All right.
What if you never turn back on?
Well, no way around that.
Yep. Shut me down.
See you in a minute.
Oops. Sorry. Bleh. Oops. There we go. How you feeling? You look good. You look happy. Uh-oh. Are you okay? Oh my God, that was like...
2 attacks in one day. I'm breaking records.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Well, did you find out anything?
Yes.
Did you find your number?
My number? Oh, no, not yet. But I did learn what the children were treated for. Remember I told you that the shape of objects was important to them?
I do.
Well, their illness was called morphophobia, fear of a shape, or to be more precise, an aversion to it.
What kind of shape?
The human body.
What?
They couldn't stand the sight of a human body. That was their disease.
What do you mean that they couldn't stand it?
They would literally get sick, vomiting at the sight of any person. Their teachers, doctors, passers-by, their own parents, even seeing each other in the mirror.
What?
What did they dislike so much about the human body?
We never did find the answer. The children weren't able to articulate their feelings. First of all, they were really young. And secondly, they were unable to communicate at all with anyone. Any attempt at communication caused suffering and psychogenic vomiting.
What? How could you even... I don't...
Is that real?
Wait a minute. Should we... Hold on. Hold on, guys. Wait a minute. I'm Googling this. Morphophobia. Definition of morphophobia. No definition. Oh, okay. No. Morphophobia doesn't exist, but dysmorphophobia does, which we know. So, alright, whatever. What an unusual disease.
Yes. Which is why the treatment was likewise unusual. Now I know the purpose behind those strange activities. Playing with cubes, collecting parts, and so on.
So why were they assembling an embody on stage?
To cultivate in the children a positive association with the sight of a human body. They were using those bits to independently assemble a fairy tale character, a positive character. And thanks to their efforts, a young woman would take the stage, the defender of beauty, protecting a blossoming garden from a wicked witch.
The witch symbolized ugliness?
Evidently. Beauty would triumph over ugliness, and the children rejoiced at their involvement in bringing about a happy end. Bit by bit, their repulsion toward the human body was thus dislodged from their psyches, replaced by a new mindset, which filled the human body with beauty and goodness.
Why did they need to go through a transfer?
The transfer anchored this mindset. All the emotional experience obtained at the Gravera Garden would anchor only in a new body. Otherwise, the therapy had no effect.
I see. And the cubes? What was their purpose?
The cubes have an extremely simple shape. Playing in the pavilions blunted the kids' excessive sensitivity. Their psyches were being simplified so as to start sewing in them trivial categories. Good and evil, beauty and ugliness. Because their perception developed in an anomalous manner, the kids saw the world of shapes very differently, in a way that grown-ups could never understand. And there was no other way to save their lives other than to make them simpler.
I'm still having trouble understanding.
Me too, sir.
Hold on.
Holding.
Meyer. Hennebish. My name is Ida Meyer.
You remembered?
I found a journal. It contains my data. Here. Ida Meyer, age 26, city of Geneva. My personal number. And a date. August 15th, 2058. What year is it, by the way?
76.
Whoa. So, I'm a psychologist from Geneva, and I've been lying in Mongolian soil for 18 years.
In a candy box. And not in soil, but in sand.
Very well, in sand. And now I'm in a flower vase, trying to verify my number. Only, damn it.
What?
It's not working. The network interface, I can't get online.
I guess the vase doesn't integrate with the web.
Hennebish, there's another network terminal, underneath the TV. It's functional, only without power. If you can power it up, I'll be able to get online.
Okay.
I'll try. Let's see how the wiring is done.
I'm so, like, I don't know. This game is beautiful and interesting, but the, like, narrative thread that they've created is really hard for me to go along with. This whole idea of, like, ugly people versus beautiful people, creating different hormones in their bodies that could keep people alive, and like, I don't know. It's weird. Like, every time we get new information, I'm like, okay, where in this strange storyline does this apply? You know? I'm still just confused. Okay, let's see. The on button is jammed.